So let's go into your reading here, and let me just talk about your career and finance sector. So first of all, we have here the money house. So this is the second house. We have here the Queen of Wands. And the Queen of Wands basically indicates a situation where we are pretty much, sitting pretty, having a lot of responsibilities, managing other people, taking care of things, and not having to get our hands dirty. Okay, so a lot of you are in a position where you're either working remotely, you're handling people from afar, you're only called in whenever there's like, massive problems and you're gonna have to do some damage control. So I feel like you're in a very upper tier type of a position, and you can affect a lot of positive things in your work environment. So this is a card about, gaining all the expertise and all the necessary skills so that you can do your job well. There is a natural flow in the work environment. And I do sense some of you are thinking about as well of long-term financial, earnings. So you might be kind of like on top of your career, and you're thinking about where you can excel or where you can move yourself to, or in which direction your career is going to take, so that you can increase your income generating potential. So I'm seeing a lot of people right now who have already learned everything there is to know about their job. So they're kind of like in the zone at work. And so there is a sense of a little bit of boredom about you. And you might also be looking for other, other positions that are opening up internally, like higher positions, higher salary, higher pay, or you might even be looking outside of the company. But either way, I feel like there's a little bit of a boredom type of energy about you where you want to learn something else. You feel like you're already the top at your career and you want to move ahead. And I'm sensing that there's a lot of trust coming through when it comes to your supervisors or your boss or whoever it is that you're reporting to. There's a lot of support, there's a lot of mentorship, and there's almost this sense of like forgiveness. Whatever you do, I feel like your supervisor, your boss understands what you're trying to do, what you're trying to achieve. And so they're giving you a lot of leeway. They're also very hands-off as well. They don't micromanage, and they leave you to your own devices. So I feel like, you're in a really good position right now. There are certain days where I feel like you feel like you want to branch out, and you feel like you're kind of pigeonholed into a specific niche in the labor market. So you want to expand your skills a little bit, and you want to learn some more things so that you can get yourself into different position, or even thinking about transferring, even thinking about traveling to a different environment altogether. So there is I'm almost sensing like a fantasy about you, where you're just like, I wish I could, go live in this city, go live in this state, go live in this country. And you know that physically it's doable, but it's not entirely realistic right now. So I see this daydreaming mode about you in your work environment. At the same time, I do feel like there might be some, be very careful about your car, okay? Especially if you are commuting for work for this month, be very, very careful about your car. Using your vehicle to commute to work, just make sure everything is checked up and be careful about driving on the road. I do sense something, it's like inclement weather, a lot of rain, a lot of hail, or just some weird weather patterns. So just make sure you check your vehicle, bring it in for inspection, and drive very carefully for this month. The second thing coming through, and I'm going to go back to the relationships. For those of you who are socially dating, who have met somebody new, you're not exclusive yet. What I have here is this, the Two of Cups. And the Two of Cups in the reverse basically indicates a situation where we are, excited about a new person, but innately we know that there is a lack of compatibility at the foundational level. There's a lack of compatibility here. Different life experiences, different upbringing, different value system. And I feel like, this is somebody that you have recently met. And I feel like it might also be somebody you're meeting through mutual friends. So you might have mutual friends and you automatically gravitate towards each other, or you find each other in that way. But as you get to know each other, you might not have very much in common. And I feel like it might be a water sign for some of you. So this is a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, or Rising. And I'm feeling that the attraction is there, But I'm almost feeling like, lack of compatibility, lack of mutual understanding, having difficulties figuring out where the other person is coming from, and they likewise have trouble figuring out where you're coming from. So be careful about this energy. It seems like, it's the opposite attract types of energy is very strong. It brings about great chemistry. It brings about, really intense flirtation and really intense physical attraction. But I feel like something, the innate compatibility is missing here. So you want to take this very, very slow. Okay. So don't make any commitments yet. Just take it very slowly. And further down the line, I do feel that you might not, because the attraction is strong, but because of that lack of compatibility, you might not want to form a relationship with this person. So in your seventh house relationship sector, we have here the Magician. This is somebody who acts like, they're single. So this is what I classically call like the bachelor or the bachelorette, whoever you're dealing with. I feel like somebody has a little bit of a commitment problem. They love their independence a little bit too much. And I feel like they're somebody that has a lot of suitors, has a lot of people on their plate, has a lot of projects, have a lot of things going on in their lives. Very, very popular as well. And so this energy is telling you to be a little bit careful when you're dating, because what you want out of the relationship is not matching up with what the other person wants. And honestly, Libras, I feel like it might be that you're not ready for a relationship and the other person is, or vice versa. But I feel like it seems to me like, with a lot of dual signs, and this is Gemini, Libras, Pisces. With a lot of dual signs, I feel like you want a relationship. And you might take the fact that, oh, I want a relationship for granted. And so you go out into the world dating people and too eager and too willing to fit that person into your relationship sector. And you're kind of blindsided. You might not choose the right people that are appropriate for you. So that's the same energy that I'm feeling here. And then others of you, I feel like you want the closeness, the intimacy in that relationship. You want somebody to, have share like your new experiences with, but you might not be emotionally ready to invest exclusively in one person. So it's really important for us to be very clear about our intentions when we're dealing with another person, because I feel like you might potentially, end up hurting the other person. So be a little bit more sensitive to what is necessary, what's needed to maintain a relationship, and be very clear about your intentions before you make promises, okay, for this month. And the energy is going to flow both ways too, but I feel like this needs to be said because this energy, I feel like it's coming through in the spread, okay? So having said that, that whole concept about re-examining the past and thinking really clearly about why the last relationship ended, and who did what and all of those things. Really sifting through, fact from fiction so that you can come to a better understanding as to, why the other relationship didn't work out, okay? So if you have recently ended a relationship, I feel like you are single here. Other people are telling you to date, and you're just like, no, I'm not ready. I'm still recovering from that past relationship. So I'm just going to play, just be single for now. So the opportunities are for dating, for mingling is around you. But I still feel like there's some hang up from that past relationship where I'm seeing guilt here. I'm seeing guilt coming through in this spread. And I'm also seeing like a lot of excitement, a lot of chemistry, but lack of compatibility. And as a result of that, you're grappling with what you know, which is there's no compatibility, versus what you feel, which is the chemistry, that really strong romantic vibe, that really strong, it's like passion in that relationship. So what you feel versus what you know, that's a little bit more difficult for you to get over, I feel. So I'm gonna go into your relationship sector in a little bit, but it's it They're just telling you to slow down overall for this month. So if you don't feel like you want to socialize, if you don't feel like you want to go out and make new connections, that's perfectly fine. And I feel like you know yourself best. But I feel like the energy here is just, coming to terms with what's appropriate for us and what's not. That's going to be really important for this month, okay? I'm also sensing of some of you are taking your responsibilities a lot more seriously. So especially for those who are on the younger end, okay? And younger, I would say like 35, below 35, 30, 35 and below. So whether or not you're still in school, I feel like you're taking care of your practical responsibilities. Setting aside money, trying not to be late on your credit card bills, trying not to be late on paying off student loans, trying to do things in a very diligent manner. I feel like there has been a and so I feel like you're learning from that and you're thinking how you can stay ahead of the game, how you can take care of things as they creep in. So you're doing a lot of planning, you're doing a lot of just growing up when it comes to taking care of paying the bills, buying books, sacrificing emotional spending so that you can have that extra money to for a rainy day. And I feel like it's a little bit challenging, but you're making good strides, okay? So don't steer away from or don't like so stick to that budget, okay? And even if for some of you who are traveling, I just keep seeing this this boundary thing when it comes to traveling. A lot of you might be planning a trip. You might be traveling with another person, or some of you are traveling with a romantic partner. And I'm feeling like there's going to be problems when it comes to finances because one person expects the other one to fill in the gap. It's like to automatically, foot the bill. And I feel like there's something unwritten, unspoken here, and the other person is going to feel a little bit resentful. Okay, so having that clear budget if you're traveling, that's going to be really important for this month. In your housing situation, what I'm sensing is this. I feel almost like I feel like geographically, so let's just say for some of you, you might live, so those of you who are not in a city center, you might live kind of like on the outskirts of town, a little bit further away from the main population cluster, a little bit further away from all the restaurants, all the nightlife scene. And I feel like, your friends are trying to reach out, telling you where to go and telling you to meet them and telling you about, this and that that they're doing. And you feel almost like it's an inconvenience having to go out of your way to get to where things are happening, to get to where people are congregating. And so you might have, turned down a lot of invitations in the past. And a part of you feels almost as if it's not fair that I always have to, commute out of the way to meet them. Why don't they come to me? And so the problem then lies in the fact that maybe we should open up our place, our house, our apartment, or condo, open up your place of residence so that the opportunities for fun, excitement, socializing, and meeting up with friends, so that the people come to you. So I feel like that's going to solve a lot of your problems, and it feels to me like it's a very mundane thing to bring up, but I feel like there might have been some imbalances here about constantly having to go out of your way to connect with friends, and you don't see the effort being reciprocated. And so they're saying like, it is an exchange of energy, and you need to make yourself available where you're at and see if they want to meet you there, okay? So social relationships overall, they need to be somewhat sorted out, balanced out, because I feel like you might have lack of compatibility, a lack of compatibility with the people that you're socializing with, hanging out with, trying to connect with. There's just overall, you might have drifted apart, you might have grown apart, because it feels like they're not entirely sensitive to your needs, and they're not the types to, just want to reach out and have heartfelt conversations with you. They might just want to go out all the time and not have to, interact heavily. So you want to really reassess the friendships as well to see if they give you that emotional satisfaction, or if there's that emotional fulfillment from your friends and from the activities that you're doing together as a group. Okay? So the career looks very, very good. I feel like there is going to be a lot of support coming through, and I feel like it seems to me as if, well, we have this card here. We have the Chariot in your work sector. So this is more of like a lull, a little bit of a slowdown as well. And what it's saying here is that this is not going to be, like a forever thing. It's going to the energy will pick up for you, and I feel like the summer time frame. So use this time to really, tie up loose ends, finish up projects, as well as figuring out how you can upgrade your skills, or even, where you need to be so that you can. I feel like some of you are at in a flow state of mind when you're like in a work environment. So you already have learned all the skills. So think about where you can apply your skills and think about where you're headed next so that you can increase your income generating potential. So that might even be, getting in touch with other companies in the same industry and see if they have an opening. That can be doing online job search just to see what's around you. And this is a little bit of a slow month, I feel, in the work sector. So it might be a good time for you to, branch out and dabble a little bit, okay? Relationships. I feel like the imbalances from there, it needs to be sorted out. And so the slowdown when it comes to your responsibilities overall, I feel like you need to divert this time to work on your relationships and try to figure out, where the weak links are so that you can do some damage control so that you can, re-strengthen your relationships, okay? And that is relationships with family, relationships with friends, and love relationships as well, or even people that you're just casually seeing, okay? So spending more time in that, I feel it's going to be good for you, okay?